In this film, we will explain what will happen in your Scottish Employment Tribunal video hearing. It's normal to feel nervous or anxious about tribunal hearings. We have created this short film to help you prepare. You can watch this film as many times as you want to. You can pause, rewind, or restart it at any time by using the buttons at the bottom of the screen. You can turn subtitles, also known as closed captions, or CC, on or off. Video hearings are run in the same way as hearings that take place in a tribunal building. The difference is that some or all of the people taking part will join the hearing online rather than travelling to a special building. The fact that your case is being dealt with by video hearing does not in any way make it less formal or less important. A video hearing has exactly the same rules to ensure that everyone involved is treated fairly and with respect. If you have any concerns about taking part in a video hearing after watching this film, you should contact the tribunal staff. You can find their contact details in the letter or email they have sent you. Talk to them about your concerns. They may be able to help you to find a quiet space and a computer. It's also possible to ask for a tribunal hearing where you meet in the same room as other people, but this may take longer to organise. This film provides answers to the following three key questions. How can you prepare for your hearing? What will happen on the day? How should you behave in the hearing?
Let's start with some tips about how you can prepare for your hearing. Details about how to connect to your video hearing and how long has been set aside to hear your case will be sent to you before the day in the Notice of Hearing. This document contains important information. Make sure you have it to hand for your hearing. You can connect to the hearing from a computer, tablet, or mobile phone from home or somewhere else of your choice. Video hearings work best when you use a computer or large tablet on a flat surface and Wi-Fi. Using your phone may mean that you use up credit very quickly or have connection issues. The device you use also needs to have a camera. If you do not have a computer, tablet, or access to Wi-Fi, find out if a friend can help you. You can also contact the tribunal's staff or the advice services we list at the end of this section for help.
It's really important to test the equipment you're using before the day of your hearing to make sure it works. This is especially important if it's a computer or tablet you haven't used before. Trying out the system may also allow you to see what you look like on screen before the hearing. Try to make sure that your internet is strong and stable. If you are using Wi-Fi, it's best to sit close to the internet router or connect to it with a cable. Ask anyone who shares your home not to use the internet during your hearing. This will make your internet connection stronger. Shut down any programs that you don't need during the hearing. These can be distracting and may weaken your connection. Make sure that your device is plugged in or fully charged. You might want to keep your charger nearby. Using headphones can improve the sound quality. Charge your phone and keep it close by in case you need to contact the tribunal staff on the number in the notice of hearing. It's best to have this number saved in your phone before the hearing. If the tribunal staff ring you, they will normally use a withheld number. So if you get a call from a withheld number around the day of the hearing, it's a good idea to answer it.
You can connect to the hearing from any room. If possible, you should choose a place that is quiet and private. You may need to show the tribunal that there is no one else in the room with you. Tell others not to interrupt or disturb you during the hearing. This will help you to focus on what is being said. Think about what's in the part of the room you will be in for the hearing. Try to make sure that what you're wearing and what's behind you won't distract other people. The length of the hearing depends on the case. If you have young children, it's a good idea to ask a friend or relative to look after them during the hearing. This means that everyone involved will be able to focus on your case. During the tribunal, both sides will refer to documents that support their case. You will need to provide the other side with any documents you intend to rely on in advance. When gathered together, the documents both sides rely on may be called the file of documents, the productions, or the bundle. In most cases, the employer puts together the file of documents, but you will receive more details on this in a case management order. This will be sent to you before the date of the hearing. All the parties in the case, the judge, and other panel members will receive the same file of documents with the same page numbers. You may receive the file of documents by post or by email. If you receive it by email and would like a paper copy, print it out in advance. If you are happy to read it on screen, it's a good idea to have a second computer or tablet to look at it on. You can also open it in a separate window on your computer. Make sure that you have the file of documents with you on the day, as other people will refer to it during your hearing. Note the page numbers of documents in the file of documents that you want to rely on during the hearing. This is so that everyone can find the right page quickly. Go through the file of documents and make some notes about important points you want to make, evidence you have to support your arguments, questions you would like to ask other people, or how you intend to respond to questions you think the other side will ask. Use these notes as a checklist rather than a prepared speech. When you are asked questions by the other side, you must not read from notes. Just answer the questions asked as clearly as you can. You should not write on the file of documents you will be using when giving evidence to the tribunal. You may be asked to show the tribunal that you have an unmarked copy of the file of documents when you give evidence.
You can have a lawyer or advice worker at the hearing to support you, but some people present their own case. Either way, it's good to get independent advice before the hearing to help you prepare. These organisations are a good place to start. You might want to pause the film at this point to take down the details. You can find out if you can get help with legal costs, known as legal aid, at this website. Legal aid is only available in a small number of cases. If you are not comfortable speaking or understanding spoken English, or use British Sign Language, tell the tribunal staff as soon as possible before the hearing so that they can arrange for an interpreter to help you on the day. You will not need to pay for the interpreter. You can also have a friend to support you during the hearing, but do let the tribunal know in advance. If you're not in the same room as the person who is helping you present your case, it is a good idea to agree with them in advance how best to communicate in private during the hearing. If you need any other support to help you take part in the hearing, just get in touch with tribunal staff. You can observe other hearings before yours takes place. This will help you understand what to expect. If you would like to find out how to do this, contact any employment tribunal office and ask if there's a suitable hearing for you to watch. Before moving on to section 2, let's recap the most important points from this section. Contact tribunal staff if you have any problems taking part. Test your technology in advance. Read through the documents sent to you.
Let's move on to section 2. What will happen on the day? Before the date of your hearing, you will be sent details of how to join the online system used by your tribunal and when to log on to it. Connecting to the system before your hearing is due to start will prevent you feeling rushed and allow time for any connection problems to be sorted out. You may also get the chance to check that your speakers and microphone are working. After connecting with the video hearing system, you may be kept in an online waiting area until the hearing is ready to start. You don't have to do anything at this point, just stay near your screen. Sometimes hearings start later than expected. Don't worry if this happens. The staff know you are waiting, and if they need to, they will contact you. It's not unusual for computer screens to sometimes freeze or for people to lose their internet connection during a hearing. If this happens, just get in touch with Tribunal staff. The judge will understand if you are having problems, so try to stay calm. If necessary, they will stop the hearing and wait for you to rejoin. As a last resort, it may be possible to take part in the hearing by phoning in. Losing your internet connection will not affect the outcome of your case.
Let's move on to talk about who will be at the hearing. Not all tribunals use the same video hearing system, but the screen of your video hearing will be divided into a number of different windows. It's possible that people may change position on screen depending on who is speaking. Every hearing will have an independent judge. The judge is in control of who speaks and when they speak. They have a duty to make sure that the hearing is fair for everyone involved and that everyone, including you, has their say. They will help guide you through the hearing. At the beginning, the judge should ask everyone to introduce themselves. They will also explain the order in which things will happen. Most cases will be decided by the judge along with two other people called panel members. The two panel members include a person with experience of employing people and someone with experience from the employee's point of view, such as a trade union official. Some types of cases and hearings can be heard by an employment judge without any other panel members. The person or organisation you are in dispute with will also be at the hearing. Both parties may bring a lawyer or advice worker to help them present their case. In most cases, there will be witnesses. A witness is someone asked to give oral evidence to support the arguments you or the other side are making. In employment tribunals, these are usually people who you worked with or for. In other cases, they may be people you have had a job interview with. In some cases, there will also be an interpreter. Tribunal staff will not always appear on screen, but they'll be in the background to make sure that the case runs smoothly. Hearings are open to the public. This means that there may be members of the public or newspaper reporters watching the hearing, but you will not be able to see them.
In the employment tribunal, there are different types of hearings. Preliminary hearings for case management help the judge and the parties decide what needs to be done in advance of the final hearing. Preliminary hearings are also held to consider particular issues, such as whether someone is disabled. The final hearing is longer, and this is when all the evidence will be heard. The tribunal will let you know in advance what type of hearing you are attending. In this film, we will focus on the full or final hearing. At the start, the judge may ask you some questions about the issues. You will also be able to ask the judge questions about what will happen in the hearing. The judge will decide which side puts their case first. In an unfair dismissal claim, the employer usually goes first. But in a discrimination claim, the employee usually goes first. People may be asked to give evidence. If you're asked to give evidence, the tribunal will require you to promise to tell the truth. This is called an oath, or if you are not religious, an affirmation. Tribunal staff will tell you what you need to do and say. If you want to take the oath on a holy book, you should make sure that you have one with you on the day. You or your representative will have a chance to challenge the evidence put by the other side. The other side will also challenge your evidence. This is normal, but it's good to be prepared. Focus on putting your point of view across in a calm and dignified way. The length of the hearing depends on the type of case. If the hearing is a long one, the judge will make sure that everyone has a short break. You can also ask the judge if you need a break. When the evidence has been heard, both sides will be given a chance to briefly summarise their case. This is called closing submissions and is your opportunity to remind the judge of your key arguments and evidence.
When everyone has had their say, the judge and panel will make a decision based on what they have heard in the hearing and been sent to read. They will usually tell you the outcome of your case on the day, but will need to take a break so they can consider their judgment. If the case has been a long one, they may not be able to tell you the outcome on the day and will write to you as soon as possible with the outcome. You will be told when the hearing is at an end and you can leave. If you're not happy with the outcome, the organisations we told you about earlier in the film can provide advice on whether and how you can appeal the decision.
Before moving on, let's recap the most important points from this section. Log in early. Don't worry if something goes wrong, there's help available. The judge will guide you throughout the hearing. Let's move on to talk about how you should behave in the hearing. It's really important that you have your say in the hearing. This helps to make sure that the process is fair. You should let the judge know if you don't understand something, if you are unable to hear or see anything properly, if you would like to ask a question, or if you think someone has got something wrong. If you don't understand a question someone has asked you, just ask them to repeat it. If you don't know the answer to a question, just say so. If you want to say something, it's important that you don't interrupt other people. Just put up your hand. When you do speak, take your time and speak clearly. If you are using an interpreter, stop and give them time to tell everyone what you have said. People often ask what they should call the judge and panel members. The fact that it's a formal hearing means that you should call them madam or sir. Don't worry if you forget. The most important thing is to be polite.
Your camera should normally be on, which means that you'll be seen on screen throughout the hearing, whether you're speaking or not. It's a good idea to think about how you look to others. Tribunals ask everyone to show their respect by following some simple guidelines about how to act. No one should eat anything or drink anything except water during the hearing, unless they have a medical condition that requires them to. Smoke or use e-cigarettes. Bring anyone else into the room without the permission of the tribunal. Answer their phone or doorbell. And have pets in the room that could make noise and disturb the hearing. Put your phone on silent when the hearing begins. It's really important that you don't take photographs or record anything in the hearing. This is a criminal offence. Let's recap the most important points from this section. Show respect for the tribunal. It's there to help you. Use the opportunity to have your say. Be polite and don't interrupt others.
We hope you've found this film useful. Remember, you can watch it as many times as you like. If you are worried about anything, get advice from an independent advice service or contact the tribunal staff. We hope your hearing goes well.